Good morning, YouTube world. Today is Wednesday. I was about to say Thursday. Today's Wednesday. Good morning. I don't know. You know, I've had a good morning thus far. I don't know why I've been waking up and half an hour late every day since last week on Thursday. I don't know what's that about. I get up at the same time, 5:27. I did that last week on Thursday, Friday, Monday, Tuesday, and this morning. It's not my alarm because I had my alarm set at 5:15, 5:30, 5:45, and 6 o'clock, you know, 15-minute intervals. But for the last few days, I've been getting up at 5:27, so I've been praying to get revelation about that. But, you know, a couple of videos I have made over the last few days started, you know, me sharing about me being cranky some mornings, some afternoons, don't know why. Yesterday, I was going to, you know, dedicate the whole afternoon after taking care of things for other people, just basically just being by myself before I grabbed my son. Ran with him to his activities and things went another way. And it just kind of like set me off. I was just so frustrated. Kind of had like a, I think like maybe a 5-minute breakdown, you know, because I was upset. I had the whole, you know, time slot planned for me to just do nothing. Well, not nothing, but the things that I want to do. Spend time with me, myself, and I. And it transpired that way, so I was a little upset, well, a lot of upset about that. So, called my mom later that evening just to say goodnight. Again, so grateful she's alive. She's 73. A lot of people with parents even younger than that, you know, didn't wake up. So, for her to still be here, pacemaker, stroke, the whole nine, I'm grateful. Anyway, you know, she was just saying what she picked up as far as like, kind of like I've gotten off my game. She noticed like my schedule. If I'm used to reading, whether self-help books, you know, the Bible, just meditating, I had my little schedule going on. And she can tell the difference when I'm doing something different. You know, my mood changes and, you know, things you pick up in the spirit as well. And she just kind of gave it to me last night in a loving way that she can only do. It was stern, firm. You know, she would say something stern and then like be a mommy. Say something stern and be a mommy. So I think I'm just going to focus on just myself, my quiet time, my relationship with God, not trying to rip and run. You know, the two characters that you talk about in the Bible, Martha and Mary. I was Martha for more than half of my life, and then I become Mary, and it feels good. And I think the spirit of Martha is trying to creep back in. You know, there's nothing wrong with being Martha and Mary, but it's a balance. Mary was all about sitting at the feet of Jesus, praying, God, what would you have me to do? Martha, oh, I know what to do. Move out the way. Let me do this. Let me fix this. And, you know, just busy, you know, a million things to do. And with, you know, squeezing time for, you know, her prayer life or whatever. Not saying she didn't have one, but that's basically the differences between them. Martha wants to, you know, do 99 things, and Mary's happy just doing that one thing and doing that one thing well. So I guess even as I'm talking, I can see how I've gotten off, getting off kilter. Because it's not normal to, throughout the day, you can have moments that, you know, they're kind of up and down because you don't know how your day is going to turn out. But, you know, one morning can't be chipper, and then 2 hours later, I'm in a mood the next hour. So, you get the point. I'm squinting because I should have my glasses. I'm supposed to wear glasses, but I really don't. I wear them when I get a headache, and then they the prescription basically takes the headache away instead of me popping Tylenol all day. What else was I going to say? I was talking about my, I keep squinting and I look crazy. Was talking to my mom about my youngest son's father. Trying to fix my hair. I can't even really see, but okay. And he finally spoke with him yesterday. It's been a while. And he came to me and in the room and was asking me, "Mom, are you happy that I talked to my dad?" And I said, "Of course, you know, of course, baby, of course I'm happy. You know, I ask you every week, do you want to call your dad? Have you talked to him?" And he always tells me no. He wants his father to call him. And that's a whole nother can of worms I don't feel like going into or even dealing with. But I explained to him that, you know, I wasn't upset or anything. And he said I was different this time when he told me that he talked to his father. And I guess I was. I sat my son down and I basically was telling him, it's not that I'm that happy he talked to his father. I wish me and his father could be friends. We used to be very good friends before we dated, got married, divorced, things like that. But, you know, there's just certain patterns I see naturally and spiritually that a 10-year-old, of course, a parent should never discuss with their children. I never talk about his father in a negative light to him. But it's all about consistency. I've been saying that since I think I was pregnant with my son. Just consistency. You know, yes, they talked yesterday, but will it continue? Will it last? You know, so I was trying to explain to my son about consistency, and you know, he understood where I was coming from. He did, but he's still 10. You know, how God has it set up, just the way a child reverence their father. They don't care if they just robbed the bank on national TV. A child will still say, "He robbed the bank, but I love him. That's still my dad." You know, so I don't really go into it too much. I almost had to like play it off and act a little phony for a little bit, hugged him, and that part wasn't fake, but you know, just like, "Yes, I'm happy, boo. You know, you talk to your dad." And you know, he's like, "Well, grandma called first and grandma called for him." And I don't know, just pretty much shrimp. Like I shared before, his father, I blame the church too, but he's of age that he should be able to decipher the difference. I always say to him, "You're a better preacher than your better father," and that shouldn't be, that's not even how God designed it. But, you know, in the African American church, that's another video I've shared before. They train men to desire to be these great pastors, bishops, superintendents, things like that, but they don't teach them how to be a good son, a good brother, a good husband, you know, things like that. Those are the things you are first before your pastor. When you're born a male, okay, learn to be a boy, grown into a young adult, grown into a man. So you're a man before you're a minister, okay. If you have siblings, you're a brother before you're a minister. Once you get married, you can be a minister before a husband, but what comes first? Your first ministry serves at home. So, I don't know. I had shared with him that, you know, if he gets married again, that I will have to, hands down, meet who he's going to be with and things like that, being around my son, because the last person he was with, it wasn't like McDonald's. It wasn't a happy meal. I'll just say that. My son's happiness is just very, very, very important to me. And by my blogs and my videos, I'm sure you know that. But I hope the day will come that me and his father can just not even get back to how things used to be, just like on a friend level. Just having a mutual understanding, you know, naturally and spiritually. You know, I wish we were able to be friends and just sit and laugh. And I mean, we've both moved on. We have a disgustingly amazing son, you know, that we both can raise together and enjoy doing it. And hopefully, if he, well, I already know he's going to get married again. I know my ex-husband that well. I don't know to who, to when, but he's going to get married again. Which is fine, you know, which is fine. But I hope he chooses wisely this time. I really do. And even whoever she is, I hope she's safe, you know, in a natural and spiritual. She's normal. She's fit for my son's father. She's fit to be a good stepmother to my son. Because if she's not, there'll just be another situation we just have to fix. But I'm not going to go into that. But his father knows what I'm talking about. But anyway, but I hope whoever he gets with that, you know, she's a woman of God. Somebody that I can call and, you know, if my son is up there, how are things? And I mean, granted, we're not going to be going to the mall together, things like that. But just to have even a relationship with her, you know, we're all supposed to be women of God, evangelists and pastors. There's no way that we should not be able to get along, especially if we are proclaiming to be of the fold. So I'm praying, yes, whoever he links up with, I pray that it is different this time. It has to be. My son's happiness depends on it, natural and spiritual. And I pray that my son's father, you know, grows too in all the areas that he needs to. Things that I may see, things that I may not see. And even, I pray for strength and growth and maturity even with myself. Sometimes, you know, just even as women, we can want what we want when we want it. But when it comes to my son, it's just so many things that's transpired. I'm easy to get along with. Trust me, I am. I'm my father's daughter. I'm strong, firm, and stern, but I'm fair. I'm fair. Consistency, that's it. So if we keep God at the forefront, in the middle, we'll be okay. You know, just like being kept. We're kept if we choose to be. Alrighty, I even don't even realize why I even went into that, but maybe I just needed to get it up off me. I feel a little bit better. So, I'll make another video this afternoon on my way to class. I have a test today, so pray my strength in the Lord. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.